Good evening. Nice to see you. Face is becoming familiar now. This is a stinging up. So, the day has its moods and its moments and its motions. The retreat does as well. There's a rhythm, isn't there? And we're moving into a latter part of the retreat where really the emphasis is on assimilating, absorbing, integrating. Been a lot of input, and hopefully one way or another we've found our way into a slightly different space, maybe not, space where a different way of being becomes more available to us. Maybe a familiar one, but one that is hard to maintain in the midst of busy life. Maybe not a familiar one. Also one that has a particular character, given the character of the retreat. We've been focusing on imagination, so the space of imagination, whatever that might mean. The space of, the five Buddha mandala, these particular images that we're exploring. Space of people trying. Well, what is the five Buddha mandala? It's a tradition. It's a line of people imagining what these qualities look like, how they manifest, entering into those images, letting them become alive, using them as a way to find what's behind the images, the mysterious qualities of life. The indefinable things, which are often the most valuable things. And life means us as well. So I'm going to be, I'll lead a fairly open period of meditation, but I am going to read a poem. Yes, I'm going to read a poem. And one of my favorite poems. So I'll tell you the name of it, and then I'll get us into a set. I will put it on the screen. It's by an American poet called Wallace Stevens, who is one of my favorite writers. I think he's really one of the great poets of the 20th century. And his theme is the imagination. And what that means, how you can access the imagination if you're not doing it through the language of traditional Christianity or something like that. It's called The Final Soliloquy of the Interior Paramour, which is quite a title for a poem. But maybe before talking about it, I'll just say a little bit about my connection with it. So, as well as a connection with Wallace Stevens. Often, when I've been on retreat, particularly on solitary retreats, I've read this poem in the evening. It's an evening poem. The first line is, "Light the first lamp of the evening." And it's about what happens when we let the day go, when the light starts to change, starts to fade, depending on the time of year. And we enter into a quiet space. And in that quiet space, we are not alone. We're there with, as the space opens up, we're there with whatever embodies the imagination for us. What is that? You could call it our soul. You could call it the muse. You could call it a bodhisattva. give it a particular form, like Akshobhya, Amitabha, Vairocana. Paramour suggests, I've always associated it with a kind of female figure, but of course it doesn't have to be that. And the meditation practice that I've done over many years is on a female figure called Prajna Paramita. Prajna Paramita means the perfection of wisdom. And wisdom in this tradition is imagined as a beautiful female figure. In fact, in the tradition, in the visualization, you see the texts of Prajna Paramita, which is a whole body of literature. And then it's as if the letters come to life. They come alive and something emerges out of the letters. And it's a lotus. And then on the lotus emerges a figure. Anyway, there's a kind of sense of meeting something very precious. And that's the interior paramour. So I'll read the poem and just let it have its effect. It might turn out to be the sort of poem you need to read a few times. I've read it many times. I'll do my best to evoke it. But Wallace Stevens is a little bit obscure. And it's sort of exploring, what is this beautiful form that I feel I meet? Is it God? Is it the imagination? What is it? And I'd like to suggest that we just take that as a doorway to imagining or feeling a connection with that soul-like quality, whatever form that takes for you. Some of you will have visualization practices, sadhana practices on Buddhas or Bodhisattvas. Maybe that's who you meet. Maybe there's another form. Maybe it's an image like the lotus that comes to you, or the Vajra, or the double Vajra, or the jewel, or the Dharma wheel. Maybe it's something like that. Let's just allow the space. You might see something, you might feel it, it might not be anything tangible. It's a sense of contacting the imagination. So let's just settle first. And let's feel the day dropping away. Maybe there are things we wanted to get round to. Well, forget it. Forget it. No point thinking about it now. You can wait till tomorrow. Maybe there are thoughts from conversations we've been having, things we've been doing. Okay. Let's have a feeling that we're putting those down, letting them sleep. If we want an image to start us, to get us into the mood, it's that we're sitting in a room at dusk, and then we light a candle.
Light the first light of evening. As in a room in which we rest, and for small reason, think the world imagined is the ultimate good. This is, therefore, the intensest rendezvous. It is in that thought that we collect ourselves out of all the indifferences into one thing. Within a single thing, a single shawl wrapped tightly round us since we are poor. A warmth. A light. A power. That which arranged the miraculous influence here. Now, we forget each other and ourselves. We feel the obscurity of an order, a whole, a knowledge. That which arranged the rendezvous within its vital boundary in the mind. We say, God and the imagination are one. How high that highest candle lights the dark. Out of this same light, out of the central mind, we make a dwelling in the evening air, in which being there together is enough. So the invitation now is to, over the next half hour, either stay sitting, if you're happy doing that, or maybe go outside, or practice in your own way, maybe take a break. So we have another 30 minutes now for us to do that. And we could simply stay here. I think I will, just meditating in this space. And at 5:30, we'll reconvene for the final part of the evening with mantras and a bit more meditation.
I'm just going to move on now to the Vairocana mantra. Play it a couple of rounds, so it'll be about 6 minutes, and then we'll go back into silent meditation again until the end of the session. And again, use the time however you want to. Want to lie down, want to sit, just assimilating all the experiences of the day. Well, for those of you in the morning, the experiences that have arisen over the retreat. Oops, I forgot to do the most important thing.
Om Maro. Om Vairocana.
bringing our practice to a close if we want to, or are sitting on. And I, Cater, will close the room in a minute or so. Those of you in the north, I hope you sleep well. For those of you in the south, I hope you have a good day. See you all 10 o'clock UK time tomorrow for a practice morning.